Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today we will be creating a pen stand using SOLIDWORKS. We will walk through each step together utilizing features like extrude, fillet and mirror. Let's get started. First, we need to set the unit system for our design document. We will be using the MMGS unit system where length is measured in millimeter, mass in gram and time in second. Click on the unit system area and then select MMGS. The tick mark indicates that this unit system is now active. We will begin by creating a sketch of this feature, the first or parent feature of our model. Activate the sketch tool, select the front plane as the sketching plane, activate the line tool, then draw a horizontal line like this, followed by a vertical line, then again a horizontal, a downward vertical, again a horizontal, vertical, and then draw the sketch as I am drawing, and lastly a vertical line and close it. Now select these three lines one by one with the control key and apply the equal relations. Now select these two lines with the control key and apply the collinear relations. Now you can apply the dimensions. Activate the smart dimensions tool, then select this vertical line and set it to 80 mm. Then select this horizontal line, then set it to 40 mm, this vertical line, and set it to 60 mm. Select this line and 100 mm. Select this vertical line, click here and set it to 40 mm. Now select this horizontal line and set it to 10 mm. Now select these two lines and click here to set the distance between them to 10 mm. Then after all the dimensions are applied, the sketch becomes fully defined and notice all entities turn black. Next, we will extrude the sketch to add the material. Go to the feature, activate the extrude tool, then enter 60 mm as the extrusion depth and select midplane options to add the material symmetrically on the both sides of the sketching plane. You can see the preview of the extruded feature. Now click on the green tick marks to confirm the creation of the extruded feature. We will now add another extruded feature by creating a new sketch on the front face of the model. For the sketch, activate the sketch tool, select this face, and you are now in the sketching environment. Activate the line tool and then draw a vertical line like this, followed by a horizontal line, a vertical line again like this. Select it. Now activate the spline tool and then create a spline with four control points, one here, and now close it like this. Now you can apply the dimensions. activate the smart dimensions tool and select this edge, select this line and set it to 10 mm, select this line, this edge and set it to 10 mm. Select this vertical line and set it to 108 mm. Select this line, this edge and set it to 10 mm. Now select this vertical line and set it to 65 mm. Select this point and this one and set the vertical distance between these two points to, let's say, 10 mm, and then select these two points again and set the horizontal distance between these two points to 30 mm. Now select these two points and set the vertical distance between them to 30 mm, and now select these two points again and set the horizontal distance between these two points to 40 mm. Now you can see after applying all the dimensions, the sketch become fully defined and all entities turn black. We will now extrude this sketch to add material. Go to the feature, select the extrude boss tool and set the extrusion depth to 10 mm. Click on the green tick mark. To smooth edges, we will now create a fillet using the fillet tool. Activate the fillet tool. Next, activate the full round fillet button. To create the full round fillet, select these three faces one by one and one here. You can see the preview of the full round fillet between faces. Next, click on the green tick marks to confirm the creation of it. We will now mirror the previously created extruded and filleted feature to the other side. Select the front plane as the mirroring plane. Activate the mirror tool. Then select the feature to be mirrored. Choose the extrude feature and fillet to the mirror. You can see the preview of the mirrored feature. Click on the green tick marks to confirm the creation of the mirrored feature. We will now create a sketch on the left face of the model for new extrude feature. Go to the sketch, activate the sketch tool, select the left face. You are now in the sketching environment. Activate the corner rectangles and draw two corner rectangles one by one, like this one, again like this. Now activate the smart dimensions tool and set distance to 15 mm and this one to 10 mm. Go to the feature, activate the extrude boss tool and extrude the sketch to a depth of 60 mm. The preview of the extruded feature appears. Click on the green tick mark. Now we need to create a reference plane. Go to the reference geometry and select the plane. Click on this face and this one. A preview of the reference plane in the middle appears. Click on the green tick mark button to confirm the creation of the plane. Now activate the mirror tool and select this plane as the mirroring plane, and then select the extruded and filleted feature. The preview appears. Click here to confirm the creation of the mirrored feature. You can hide the plane from here, hide it out, and you can see the current model is look like this. We will now add a circular cut. So go to the sketch, activate the sketch tool, then select this face to create a sketch. Activate the circle tool and then draw two circles, one here and one more here. Activate the smart dimensions tool and select this point, this edge, and set it to 30 mm, this point and this edge, and set it to 30 mm. Similarly, select this point, this edge, and set it to 30 mm, and this point, this edge, and set it to 30 mm. Now set the diameter of this circle to, let's say, 30 mm. Similarly, second one also, let's say, set it to 30 mm. Now you can create a curved feature by removing the material. Go to the feature, press Ctrl 7 for the isometric view, activate the extrude cut tool, and you can see the preview appears by removing the material. Select the up to next options, click on the green tick marks to confirm the creation of the feature. Now apply the constant size fillet to the edges. Activate the fillet tool and then select the constant size fillet button. Next, select the edges one by one and this one, and define 10 mm as the radius of the fillet here in this field. Click here to confirm the creation of the fillet. Here is the final model after creating all its features. To finish, we will now apply material to the model. So go to the material, right click, click on edit material, and then select the woods tab and select teak woods, apply and close. And that's it. You have now created a pen stand in SOLIDWORKS. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.